I'm willing to make some off-color jokes, but not some off.
Someone thought about it.
Yeah.
I feel like I don't even have to watch the chat because everyone that shows up in the chat is now on the show. So.
I mean, I can bounce out if that makes you feel better.
No.
Get off the show and get in the chat. Right fucking now.
Get in the chat where you belong, woman.
You get out of my dreams and get into sir. My chat. Can't handle all this daylight. This is terrible.
Fuck that.
I mean, not you. You look good.
No, I look like complete shit. I sound like I was sucking dick all night.
Good for you. It's just...
That's an improvement for Matt, huh?
No, I meant you got a real case of dick all night. I know you enjoy it. It's nice. It's a bevy, a plethora of peni.
I woke up this morning and my mouth tasted like I was just chewing on a butthole all night.
I like how you have a reference point.
Man, sometimes you gotta eat an ass.
Gotta, wanna, have so, to. Shoulda,
quick thing, coulda. And then we'll actually start recording. But there was a Reddit thing, and people are talking about like weird ways that they went to the ER. And this one guy was talking about how he had to go to the ER and get his lungs pumped because he was eating his girlfriend's ass in the shower, and the water was running down her butt crack directly into his mouth and into his lungs.
So he had shit water in his lungs.
Shit water in his lungs.
Wow.
Yeah.
I figured, you know, maybe they'd wait till after the washing process if they're going to do something really, like that.
Is that really like a pleasurable thing? Has anyone had their asshole licked? I mean,
no, I haven't.
Me neither.
Waiting for Ashley to jump in and be like, yeah, it's great.
Right?
No.
Ashley?
No,
you don't know love till you've tossed a salad.
Corey's like, Corey's awful quiet.
It's because my mouth is full.
He got a bunch of butthole in his.
Sorry, I can't speak right now. I have a mouthful of sphincter.
Just playing the butt. Tom.
Hang on a second. Yeah. What do you need?
Oh. What the fuck is happening? Do you want me to smile for her?
Do you guys want to say hello to my mother?
Oh, it's your mom, not your woman. Sure.
Oh, God.
Now, what does she go by? Della?
Della, she, you, yeah.
Della Sue.
Deli Sue, here, hang on.
No.
Oh. No.
There she goes.
Hi.
Oh, she ran.
Say hello.
Hi.
Hi.
That was awesome. She's fucking internet famous now. I need her to sign a waiver saying that she won't sue.
I like how she walks into the room when you're talking about eating assholes, by the way.
I know. It was really, really disconcerting for me. I should have locked the door. I can't.
Put a fucking tie on the door.
Yeah, I can't wait to not live here anymore. It's gonna be great.
The cowboy hat on the other side.
Yeah, right.
You want to do this? You can say no. We have to record it anyways, so say yes, please. Thanks, guys.
Yes.
Thank you.
What are we saying yes to? I'm agreeing before I know what I'm agreeing to, and that gets me in trouble.
No, I'm gonna actually like start the show now.
I mean, I have to legally not say anything because it will hold up in a court of law if I don't encourage you vocally.
Fuck. Two quick things that I forgot.
Well, I'll give you a verbal waiver of any sort of harassment, name calling, and degrading.
I was only kidding. I'll try and keep it to a minimum.
Hit me with your best shot.
It's a good song. Fire away. Corey, I'm gonna introduce them before we do the for more on this podcast thing.
Sure.
So I want to move that, and then also afterwards, if you can stick around, I want to re-record the hate and status fear ad into one, so I don't have to keep switching it. But I want you there so that we're both on it.
Okay.
Because I'm sick and fucking tired of keeping track of who's on what and where. And then we'll worry about that later. But assuming you have time, this could be a 4-hour podcast.
Oh god, I'm gonna have to go plug into a charger somewhere.
No, it's not gonna be. I can't handle that today.
No.
Are you talking about your vibrator?
No, that's battery operated.
I assume it kickstarted.
It's heavy duty. It's got the drawstring pull. I
right. Oh,
mm. All right, I'm gonna start
recording. You just beat your Egyptian slaves like mush. Oh no, that's that.
The visual of that, Ashley. You got your foot on it, and you're yanking the ripcord.
Yeah.
Give it some choke. Choke it. Would it help if I get out of anyway?
Oh shit! I love it.
You guys ready?
Don't wait for us, man. It's just going to get worse from here.
Oh, I know.
I know.
At least, like, start recording, and then we can talk about
now I just pee.
Recording vibrators.
We've been here so long, I have to piss again.
Do you want to pee quick?
Yeah, I'll be right back.
All right.
You're short of shit on me.
I'm 45. I haven't peed quick in, like, 40 years.
I'm catching up, man. We'll see. Things are getting a little swelled down there.
Oh, boy.
It's like you can judge what the weather is outside by the sting. Well,
things are getting swollen down there.
It's like a saltiness. I feel like there's
buttholes and ripcord vibrators, and now he's got to go relieve himself in the bathroom. Like, I'm not really sure what's going on around here.
He's going to go beat off real quick.
I love how he's not here to hear this either.
Yeah, he'll be back. He can watch the video on YouTube.
I love it. This is actually probably a good time for me to make sure my power sources and all this are situated.
Probably.
Should I tell my children to leave me alone and get my coffee? And
hey, fuckers. Mommy's going to be busy for about 45 minutes. I'm sure they're used to hearing that.
Yeah, right.
Mommy's bringing home a friend.
Yeah, I wish.
You like Uncle Rod. He always brings you comics. Oh, the flashback. Fuck. Oh, God.
How long are you going to be around, Mom?
A while. Why?
Just wondering. Because I'm in the middle of recording, or not recording. I got...
Actually, we will.
Well, yeah. Stumbled into this showness, and if you can help contain those demons in the other room to leave me alone for a little while.
I thought you were supposed to be hanging out with your kids.
I am, and I'm taking a half an hour break. Well, oh my God, Mom.
I'm the only one here. How does this always happen? I'm like the least photogenic out of everybody. It's rude. That's what it is.
Right, that's why I put a like... Put a thumbnail picture up there and like video access. No, thank you. not today. Today's not a good day for that.
It's weird. I make an effort to like go and shower and look presentable and brush my teeth and everything for doing the show with Matt because he's just so dreamy and. I'm about as far away from him in the country as I can get.
There he is.
Yeah, I locked the door. No more mothers impeding on my sphincter talk.
Uh-oh. You still hear me okay?
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, good. For just a moment, I need my little special vapiness because I'm cool like that now.
Welcome to that douche train.
I know, I like it. And
I'm sure Ashley's been trained before. It's fine.
It's apparent.
It is true. That night, I'd forgotten my coffee out here, so that's an important part.
Do you want to just do it from the Quiver Mart, Ashley, or?
No, I left it in my car. I'm walking back inside. I'm getting it. Good God.
Good God.
It's my lifeline.
It's important to do these for YouTube, by the way.
Oh, God. I'm going to fall over. We're going to try to take my boots off with the creepers on. Yeah, I don't think the internet connection will stay strong out there.
Probably not. So I grabbed the mics for the first time in, I don't know, 15 years. We'll see how that goes.
Brian and Anthony.
Right. The only other thing I have to try out to see next time if it sounds better is whatever headset you pandered off to me.
Yeah, I just don't know what you would connect it to. You don't have a PC, right?
No, not at the moment. Because I'm awesome like that.
Right.
You know, it would be even better if I could find a close by outlet where I'm not bending over like on the floor trying to reach it.
Bending over on the floor, eh?
Somewhere.
This is like Ashley's Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. She just describes everything she's doing. Here's my entire entire thought process while I get to the answer.
Are you not used to this yet?
Oh, I just don't listen usually.
Oh, thank you.
Usually I just let you do it, and, you know. What is this, just our show now? What happened to Matt and Corey? Gone?
I'm still here.
Oh, hello. Yeah, I don't know what happened to Matt. He's got his little mute thing.
Fire the pussy!
There he is.
I had to get more coffee and graham crackers, and my wife wanted to talk.
Ah. About your unhealthy habit of eating graham crackers and coffee in the morning?
There's fucking 1:30 in the afternoon, you prick.
Yeah, for you it's morning though, isn't it?
No, I was up at like 9, which is still probably the latest I've slept in a long time.
I got up at 9. Well, I got up just before 9.
I thought about like sleeping in, but then I'm like, no, I'm going to fuck myself tomorrow, and then it's going to be worse on Tuesday. Right in the microphone.
All right, sorry, I'm back. Child fights.
Did you tell him to fuck her in the pussy? What team are your kids on?
What now?
What team are your kids on?
What team?
Yeah, Gryffindor. Are they boys or girls? One of each?
Boys. Boys, two boys.
And tell them to grab him by the pussy then.
Like oil and water.
And yet one is named Nancy, so figure that shit out.
What?
Nancy? She has a son named Nancy.
Apparently.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
No.
Okay. Yeah, I believe Brandon, not you.
His name is Nancy.
I never believe women. They just lie. All right.
So there's no video for you, Ashley, huh?
No, not that'll today. Kill
your, I mean, there could be. I think I could force turn it on if I really wanted to be a dick about it.
That's all right. I've got a thumb. I can cover up the lens.
No, it's fine.
I don't think I can. Gotta save that for the anal gland.
Wow.
Do you know how they get a quote natural flavor of raspberry and vanilla?
Is it a
beaver glands?
Yeah.
What it's what? What
it's beaver glands? It's beaver anal glands
from the anal glands of beavers.
Hmm.
Oh wow, you think that's interesting? You wait until I go into the whole diatribe about bananas I read this morning.
Oh god.
Can we record this podcast first so I can leave? Sorry.
Not that I've got any place to go. Just as
where are you gonna go? You're gonna be in the fucking chat afterward.
I need to fucking go back to my easy chair. But I can play PlayStation. I guess I could do. I could play PlayStation while we're recording this and really just be phoning it in.
I hear that's how these things work now.
What me
that's
phoning it in?
More than 7 listeners is they play PlayStation on YouTube.
That's true.
That holy is the magic.
Fuck. Okay, so I don't know if whatever. I saw someone was there's the subreddit for the Friday the 13th game. I don't know if we talked about this. I may have drank it away, but they were complaining because like people were talking about how the Mortal Kombat character of Jason is so popular that they're giving him his own video game now, and like people didn't know who Sam Raimi was, and I'm like.
That's akin with Kanye making Paul McCartney famous.
Oh god damn it.
Which is just it's just
why did McCartney stoop to that level?
Mm-hmm. When I was
Kanye and I just fucking cringe.
When I was a kid, I had people say the same thing like that. That fucking band that showed up in the Run DMC video, they're shit. I don't know why they let them do that. That was Run DMC's song. Like Aerosmith?
Are you kidding me?
Aerosmith showed up and walked this way, and wow, they should have really stayed home.
Well,
wow is correct. I'm just gonna start. I'm just like asking you guys for permission.
Oh, we haven't started yet?
No.
I'm ready.
Yeah, of course you are.
We've done a whole show already.
I don't know.
It feels like this is 90% of the content of the show.
Welcome to episode 72 of the Podcast of Terror, production of the Galactic Network. It's the podcast about all things scary. I'm your host, Matt Stein. With me, as always, is Cordy Scott. Yeah, nothing, man. I'm having a rough day. How are you?
I feel like I've been downgraded in the new year. What the fuck? That's harsh. Like, we have always our little banter back and forth, and I feel good about it at the end. No,
I
feel hurt.
God, your 10 seconds to talk is up, right? We talked about this before. We're starting a fucking timer when you talk.
I saved that for else nerds.
Now you got me. Now you got me uncomfortable and sweaty. The first show of 2017. I'm already sweaty.
How I wanted you.
Oh, whatever. This week we were joined by some guy named Brandon Raymond and a dumpster slut named Ashley Gagnon. Hey, guys.
Hey. I like how they rhyme. Brandon rhymes with slut.
Random slut. Brandon random slut.
Just so our listeners understand, Ashley okayed the...
Yeah, she did. I did ask her if I could call her a dumpster slut before I called her a dumpster slut.
I don't even
think
we brought that to the table. I think that was already on the table. Yeah. We were just like, oh, if we're going to pick random things up. Like,
yeah, she's just self-proclaimed. It's fine.
Yeah, she... Okay. So that bears explanation that she wasn't supposed to be here. And then we were testing Hangouts with her, which is what we used to stream to YouTube, for something that her and Brandon are planning on doing. And we're like, well, you might as well just hang out. She's like, well, I haven't watched the movie. And Corey's like, well, neither have I. So then here we are with an extra guest.
Yay.
Nothing wrong with that. She's a fan. Super fan.
It's true.
Yeah. I mean, your chat room is here. You're good.
Yeah, I don't even have to pay attention to YouTube chat right now because it's currently on the show. Yeah. Thanks, guys. Well, thanks for coming, I guess, kind of.
Hey.
Yeah.
Whatever.
Hi.
Whatever. I don't care. I'm here to make your show terrifyingly bad.
Well, I do that on my own. I don't need you for that.
Pretty sure I'm going to take the gold on this one today.
I don't know. I'm pretty happy to be here for the sweaty edition of the show.
That makes sweaty. I had to bring a blanket because my nipples were hard. And now I'm sweaty. So
as riveting
as this what menopause is like?
For more on this podcast, including show notes, contact info, and subscription links, you can go to gncast.com/pod if you choose to. If you feel like it after this, I don't know. I'm enticed. You can chat with us on our Slack channel or just randomly show up on screen. That happens. And go to gncast.com/sign up. While you're there, you can also subscribe to our newsletter. And we are spoiler heavy. We're going to talk about Land of the Dead by George Romero.
And
we're going to call our super fans dumpster sluts. That's kind of us.
That's true. It should also be mentioned that we are recording this on New Year's Day at like...
You can tell just by looking at Matt.
The afternoon. If you're watching this, you already know because I kind of look like what would happen if a human being was run over multiple times.
Matt except for looks your a little bit like what it looks like if you were fucked to death
by a gorilla.
A dumpster.
By Ashley.
I didn't pick up the dumpster slut meant you were actually being anally rammed by the dumpster itself.
She puts on a gorilla costume and just fucks people to death behind a dumpster.
Matt Stein looks like what happens after a night with Ashley Gagnon.
God damn it. I like how your favorite activity is in your last name. And it's not true. The non-part.
Yes.
Choking on dick.
Not Gagnon, Gag Many.
Gag Many. Can you legally change your last name to Gag on them all?
Right.
I really thought that Non was the like giant dude from Superman 2, the big dumb Kryptonian, so I thought that it was like she was very specific.
What?
We'll go with it. We are open for all kinds of theories.
Gag Mon-El. Is Mon-El the Mon-El chick? That's Supergirl, Mon-El, right?
Is the dude. He's the dude from Baxum on Supergirl right now. That's
touche.
Oh, fucking.
It rhymed. That's all that matters.
I like stopped paying attention for 45 seconds to look up Superman 2 and got lost. Thanks, guys.
In the Phantom Zone?
In what?
The Phantom Zone. God damn, I swear to God, it's like the best Superman movie that's ever existed.
Is it really?
Get an education.
I have one. The government wants me to pay them back for it, too.
Ashley, can you use the cellophane S for a dental dam?
What?
I don't think so. Never tried, though.
No?
Okay. I mean, cling wrap never clings to what it's supposed to cling to.
Jesus. It clings to all the wrong spots.
The cellophane S from Superman 3, you know?
Oh, yes. Good call.
A super dental dam.
Wow. Wow. But can it stop Superman's super sperms?
48 hours, people. I want to make sure Lois didn't get pregnant because that thing's going to kick your fucking...
Line with some kryptonite dust.
Kryptonite condoms incoming. Okay.
Yeah. Well, what?
Right.
Well,
is this small rats?
Lois Lane needs to be on top because everyone knows you can't get pregnant if you're on top. It just runs out.
But then if he gets too excited, he shoots her into orbit.
He just squeezes her like a tube of toothpaste. Just. And then it
I don't want
Lois shoots out the top. Bottom.
On top is bad. I don't want a white acorn in my lap.
If you have a kryptonite condom, wouldn't that like prevent him from getting hard on?
Yeah, that's well, Superman whiskey.
Oh shit!
Wow.
Damn. That was awesome. That's the whole show right there. Drop the fucking mic.
We'll stop right there. That's the episode for the week.
Yes. Happy New Year.
Yeah. Happy New Year.
Speaking so we know how Matt's New Year's was. Corey, how about you?
I watched TV by myself until the fireworks started going off.
Did you watch just like the main networks, NBC, ABC, CBS?
No, I didn't watch any of that shit. I watched Creepy Coffee Movie Time because I'm not a
heathen. Oh, even better.
Was it on TV, the picture that you posted?
Yes. Don't have
I wasn't
friends.
Sure if you...
So...
You have me. I'm your friend.
Yeah, where were you, bitch? You were
in my house.
Humdinging yourself over a garbage can.
Fuck. I didn't puke.
No, you not shit once. Yourself.
I didn't shit myself till like 5:30 this morning.
That's good. It's good that you saved it. For the ultimate impact.
So you went all train spotting this morning?
It's like, yeah. Now we have to move, honey. Now it's not a matter of whether or not we find another house. We just have to burn this one to the fucking ground.
We need to move before this pile of shit in the backyard thaws out. I'm not picking it up.
I spend my New Year's watching the three networks, and it's a testament to how shitty NBC has become. They were relegated way to the end of Times Square, and if you switch between networks, you could see them get closer and closer. By popularity.
Was Mariah Carey on NBC?
I don't know. I didn't pay any attention to that shit. I was too busy looking at the real estate they each had.
Weird. So I'm guessing...
Mariah Carey again? I don't give a fuck.
The only reason that I know that she performed last night is because there's a video and there's no backing track to like the second verse of whatever song she was singing. And she just walks around and she's like, yeah, we didn't do this. There's no sound check, so I'm just going to strut around.
Isn't that par for the course for these entertainers now?
Yeah, no one sings. Like,
but no one tries to
actually sing.
Well, the other part of it is that while she's there live on national television when people would actually be watching and shit, she's just talking shit about the whole thing. And then anytime there's the high screaming part of the Mariah Carey song, that's when you hear the voice track kick in.
Yeah.
So it just kind of shows she's never hit those notes, certainly not in the last 15
not
years
for,
or so.
Not for decades, right?
Right.
Well,
and...
Ashley's back.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, I had to mute out for a second. Sorry. No, but, and then it like kind of like worked its way into that next song. I don't even remember what the hell it's called after her emotions. And it's like, if you're going to lip sync, you know, whatever, I guess, not cool anyways. Don't use the radio track off of the fucking radio. Like, it wasn't even like another like different recorded one. It was literally the one that they played on the radio that went smash hit. It's like the most unconvincing, lazy thing like they could have done. Like,
yeah, but you have to assume that they did that so that it would sound like what people remember it sounding like on the radio.
Right.
Yeah, I don't disagree. It's stupid. Like, fuck, whatever.
Well, I mean, it's Dick Clark's Rockin' New Year's, and Dick Clark hosted American Bandstand for all time and everything, and it was always lip synced. It's just that's par for the course with that show and with what he's always done. So it's not unusual that they'd use a track, but it's weird that it only kicked in for those parts. So it's obvious that that's what they were planning. She was going to sound like she was singing and was singing for the most part so she could interact with the audience and stuff. And then it's, oh, and here's the screaming part because there's no way in fucking hell I'm going to reach that. But it's more that she wasn't very well prepared good. As a professional, as someone who's been in the business for so long for when
right.
things went to pot. And it's also weird that the production company was so bad. And I think the whole Ryan Seacrest doing the still titled Dick Clark's New Year's Rockin' Eve thing is itself a shit show. So it'd be nice if we could just fucking change
insult.
It up now.
A complete insult to the memory of Dick Clark.
That's true.
Yeah.
Funny story. Funny thing happened to me the other night. I went out to the bar to watch the UFC fights, which was the first mistake I made. But someone posed the question. They said, would you suck Ryan Seacrest's dick for a quarter of his money? The man is worth $330 million. Okay. So I said, yes. And a guy with us goes, yeah, I'd suck his dick for a quarter.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what? He goes, you just said a quarter, like 25 cents of his money. I'd suck his dick. And I'm like, touche, sir. I still want a quarter of $330 million.
Mm-hmm.
Bring,
that's going to be a lot of dick sucking.
That bring rate. That dick over here, Seacrest. You take your little Seacrest sperms out. All right. So we're going to talk. Let's do some news. Fucking 10 minutes into this. Haven't even talked about news. The first trailer came out for the new Alien movie. I haven't watched it. I'm not a huge Alien fan, which probably people will hate me for. But I also saw that Danny McBride is in this. I don't know how
Danny
I feel about
McBride,
that.
Danny McBride is
in
it?
Yeah.
Wow. I didn't make it past. I haven't seen the new trailer, but for me, my fandom does not go past Aliens. So.
I've seen the first one. That's about it. I had really no interest in this. It comes out May 19th. Corey, Ashley, have you guys watched this thing?
No, not the trailer, not yet.
I've seen the trailer. My wife just put on Prometheus is on TV the other day. I've never seen that, so I saw about 15 minutes of it before I conked out. But this is supposed to at least get us back to something that's more of the feel of Aliens.
Right. This is supposed to bridge the gap between Prometheus and Alien, right?
Yeah, but also it feels in the way of its... The super violence aspect of it, the Ripley kind of character, that they actually, Catherine Waterson is in this, they dress her up to look similar to Ripley, although I do believe that Ripley might show up in this. I'm not 100% sure on that.
Are they, does it look like they're going the way of Force Awakens and just redoing the first movie?
Maybe. And maybe that's not a bad thing to do. I mean, Alien itself was a really good sci-fi movie, but Aliens is what begat us Space Marines, you know, which changed, well, which invented a new genre, essentially.
See, that for me is what the prequels in Star Wars are. The, just giving us that expanded universe, that is where the value lies in the old remade Star Wars, the episode 1, 2, and 3. It's not so much that they're great movies, but it gives us that expanded universe. That's why I like those movies.
Well,
so
the problem I had with the prequels, other than the fact that they were a shitstorm, is that they didn't expand the universe enough. It was the same characters and just going like in the backstory of them. I enjoyed Rogue One because it was an expansion. It was still kind of it was the same sort of story. It's dealing with what's about to happen in A New Hope, but it was new characters. It was different people to explore. It was different worlds to explore. It felt like, oh shit, there's more to Star Wars than just the same four or five planets and the same Skywalker lineage and everything else. And that's what I want out of it. And that's what the books did for years. That's what the comics did for years. So I'm excited to see the films going in that direction. I think that they tried that with Prometheus, and unfortunately it didn't work out. Now, it could be that it was just not a good movie, or that people had an expectation of it being Aliens and it wasn't. But this is supposed to kind of converge the two things and make a new version of something that people did enjoy. And it looks good. It looks solid.
I look forward to seeing Fassbender in it. He was my favorite part of the last one. He is in it, right? Fassbender, anybody know? No?
Yeah, Michael Fassbender is in it. Catherine Waterson, Billy Kudrup, that's a Danny McBride, which is not terribly unusual. I've seen him do stuff that is more drama-based. I haven't seen him do anything horror that I can think of.
Maybe he's new Bill Paxton. Maybe they saw him in This Is the End, and now he's going to be the game over man guy.
Shit, man, I would love to be the new Bill Paxton. That guy was in fucking everything. I mean, he gets less credit than Kevin Bacon, but he was like prolific in just all the shit he showed up in.
Dude, in the 90s, between him and Brendan Fraser, those two printed money as character actors.
Yeah.
Like, those were, like, two short-term leading men, like, the ugly leading men. But I love Bill Paxton. That guy is great.
Yeah, Paxton's only problem is that he always gets confused with Pullman.
Yeah, that's true. But if you look at like Near Dark and Aliens, that little bit of time where like Michael Biehn and him, and they all the same cast throughout all those movies. Yeah, I love that.
So apparently Danny McBride was in a movie in 2013 called As They Lay Dying. With James Franco, based on the 1930 classic by Faulkner, it's the story of the death of Addie Bundren and her family's quest to honor her wish to be buried. So that doesn't sound like a comedy or a horror, but
no.
James Franco and Danny McBride are in it. Sounds like weird shit, but
it sounds unusual if you're part of their usual fan base. I mean, I guess this is the end of the horror movie in a certain degree, but it's still a comedy. But they both have the ability to stretch outside of their realms, and so I'd be interested to see what he does with this. I could see him easily as one of the crew members in the original Alien. Even more than the Space Marine thing, I can see him being one of the people who's just on the ship, who's just part of it. I've seen a few people in those roles. It just seems like that would work.
Yeah, yeah. Corey, I need you to read the next story.
Who's just on the ship.
Because it plays audio when I open it.
Yeah, it just started playing it for me too.
Yeah.
So the next story is Neve Campbell and Kevin Williamson are talking a possible Scream 5. So now
I previously read this and it sounded like there was talks of Scream 5, 6, and maybe a 7.
After Scream 4, they were still planning on doing a 5 and 6. I don't know how 4 did. I don't know that it was widely embraced as like a moving forward of the series, but it happened. And so, of course, you know, Wes had gotten back into it. Why would he not plan on doing another trilogy for it? Yeah. But when Wes passed away, it put a real hold on, is this something that can happen? Now, from Williamson's remarks, he says, now without West, I feel like you have to sort of answer the questions of how and why, and I don't know how to do it without West, and I don't know why to do it. But Neve Campbell was a little bit more optimistic on it. She said, it would be tough to do without West. His vision was so clear and he was so good. I think it would be painful, but it doesn't mean it would never happen. It just would be challenging, and nobody's talking about it at the moment. So it's kind of like, is this a story? Is it not a story? Is it an actress like Neve Campbell who would love to get back to a series where she was the lead, because I can't think of anything much that I've seen her in outside of the Scream movies in quite a while. But it's also, we're talking about Hollywood today, and Hollywood today does not like to give up on something that they consider a franchise. You know, no matter if the creative force of it is gone, Williamson was always the writer of the film, so it makes a certain degree of sense that his voice would still be recognizable in it.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah. I wasn't hollering for a Scream 5 anyways, even if Wes was still around. I would rather have believed that Wes would do something as the next generation. Like, he'd already done Scream as the answer to the stuff that he had done in the 80s. I would have liked to see what he would do after that.
Sounds like you're not alone. Apparently a lot of people weren't super happy with how Scream 4 turned out, although it did do $97 million at the box office, which isn't great. With a $40 million budget, you only pull in $97 million. But what do I know? I have like $7 to my name.
You want to skim off $10 million of that for me? I'm fine with it. I'll fucking support you if I can walk out with a bunch of cash.
Change.
Would you suck Wes Anderson's dick for a quarter of his money?
No, just a quarter.
Hold on. Just a quarter. No, I just want 25 cents.
I like how we went to Wes Anderson as opposed to Wes Craven. I'm now dying to see a Wes Anderson directed Scream movie.
Right?
That would be terrific.
Wes Anderson's only worth $15 million, and Wes Craven is worth $40. So.
But Wes Craven is.
Suck his cold dead, dick.
So the taste is not going to go out of your mouth very quickly.
Wow.
It's going to linger.
That's what I'm saying.
I mean, he just might have to like reconstitute him a little bit.
Rehydrate him.
Tastes like grandpa.
You
want to take the next story?
I guess so.
Yeah, so I didn't mean to make that mistake between Wes Craven and Wes Anderson, but I think I'd rather suck Wes Anderson's dick.
Well, if you're talking about money, the amount of money you're coming out of it, I'd rather suck Wes Craven's dick, even though he's dead.
No, I think I'd go with Anderson, though. Grand Budapest Hotel.
There's I don't really care for his movies.
Get him. Oh, I love Grand Budapest. I think that his taste would just be up my alley.
You think it would taste like Darjeeling tea?
I hope so.
So the next story that we have is there's a new Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the Next Generation documentary has resurfaced, or it's surfaced for the first time.
Resurfaced.
Well, it looks like it's about 5.5 minutes long. But the Next Generation was what, 2 or 3?
This is the fourth.
This is the fourth one, okay.
This is the film that for a long time the people associated with it refused to acknowledge that they were in it. And that includes Matthew McConaughey and Renee Zellweger. In fact, Matthew McConaughey did his All Right, All Right, All Right in the movie. I think maybe before or just slightly after he did it in Dazed and Confused. Like, it's 94 was when it was originally released, and it was released again in 97. I can't even remember it ever hitting the theaters, but I watched it on cable one night, and it's just a fucking bizarre piece of shit.
Yeah, but that was my introduction to Texas Chainsaw, that movie.
Really?
I think it was for a lot of people, because it came out at a point in time where the next generation of kids who were watching horror movies late at night on cable, this is the one that was getting repeated. When I was a kid, I saw Texas Chainsaw 2 before I saw Texas Chainsaw. In fact, I don't think I ever saw or watched the whole thing of the first Texas Chainsaw Massacre until we did it on the show.
Oh God, I remember buying it in high school.
Oh yeah, it's my wife's.
Watch it, yeah.
What are my wife's favorite movies of all time?
So but, I was googling.
But she likes this one too.
No, so I don't think I haven't seen in their entirety in one sitting, 2, 3, or 4. But yeah, I'll have to fix that. So I was looking for Matthew McConaughey as All Right, in Texas Chainsaw Massacre, and I found a news story about how he forgot that he was even in the movie. And there's like a video clip of him talking to Jimmy Kimmel, and he doesn't remember which one he was in or that he even did it.
Wow.
So
McConaughey, I believe that on.
Wow.
He's probably sitting there smoking down with Woody Harrelson someday, playing the bongos naked. And like Harrelson puts on a mask of somebody's skin, but vegan, you know, vegan mask. And then they just like, hey, we should be in Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Oh, I think I just did that. Bullshit. Oh, okay. Maybe I didn't.
Yeah. So that exists. I'll put a link in the show notes for it. Oh, wait. The video has been removed at the request of a guy. But you can check. Oh, there's a clip below. Okay. So you can order the documentary.
Right. It was up on YouTube for a very quick minute.
I don't read things in their entirety. I'm sorry. Although if you're just finding that out now, I'm really sorry. Shut up, Puff the Magic Dragon. Fucking e-cigs and shit.
I was muting the mic when I did that, but I got lazy.
You got fucking.
It's all right. I'm out my car right now, and I forgot mine inside, so.
Good
podcasting from the car. There you go.
Your lungs.
And she, like many of our listeners, is just in the garage with the door shut firmly and lit in the fumes, and our dulcet tones just rock her to sleep.
When she muted the mic for us because she had to hook up the hose,
right?
The exhaust.
The light at the end of the tunnel looks like Matt and Corey.
Wow.
A lot of conversations end with Ashley hooking up the hose.
Wait, are we talking about like...
You guys are so nice.
Rubber hose or like the street corner hose?
That goes up your nose, sir.
That's cocaine.
Okay.
No. Not
neither of us are thin or rich enough to be doing cocaine.
That's true.
That is the truth.
My favorite thing ever is Arnold Schwarzenegger in... What is it, Red Dawn, where he's got the leg and it's... No? Nobody?
No,
nobody
ever seen it? Not Red Dawn, right?
Not Red Dawn.
What is that movie where he's...
Are you talking about the one with Jim Belushi?
Yeah, the one where he's a Spetsnaz.
Yeah.
I love that movie.
This?
Cocaine.
Ah, God, it gets me every time. Are you sure that's not Red Dawn?
No, yeah, Red Dawn is Swayze, the 80s man. One with Patrick Swayze and... All those guys.
Oh, it's Red Sonja.
Oh, Red Sonja. Okay,
never mind.
But Red Heat is the one I was thinking of.
Red Heat. All the movies with Reds. Red Sonja
was a go-to movie when I was a kid. That scene in the beginning where he's in the sauna.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to have to watch this. Red Sonja.
Red Sonja was playing off of him being Conan, so he couldn't be Conan in it. Yep. He was Nonan.
Wait. Are you serious?
That was not his name, but it's just...
Yeah, his name was Lord Calidor.
Right.
Yeah. All right. Let's do this last fucking story. Where are we? What day is it? Oh, dude. Okay. So apparently there's Bateman skincare, which was inspired by American Psycho. Can I buy this?
It is an actual product line. So they...
you know, Patrick you Bateman know when it's, you get 10% off.
A lot of stuff with skincare and a lot of like... gel cleansers and things like that. So somebody got the rights to make a skincare line based off of American Psycho. Next thing you know, they'll be making fucking soap from Fight Club. It works. It's one of those things that just fucking works, and you wonder why the hell they hadn't done this before.
That's a great point. Why wouldn't you do that? I mean, they used to market everything. Fucking cereals for movies and yeah.
I mean, Patrick Bateman cereal would make sense too.
Why not?
Yeah, I'm trying to think of what it would be.
Market everything.
Cereal killers, but if you go to BatemanSkincare.com,
it's fucking expensive.
Why would it be cheap? He's a fucking yuppie in the 80s, and that's where your cocaine comes in.
Right.
Rose hip and seaweed facial cleanser. You get a daily hyaluronic cream. I really thought that was going to say colonic somewhere. And then a hyaluronic serum. And they're not really that expensive. I mean, my wife works in beauty care. So I know how much this shit actually...
Do I look like someone that takes care of my skin?
Well, I mean, I assume that you're trying to get to about the size 14 so you can have someone make you an address.
Zeros.
Corey, you're telling me MAC makeup isn't expensive, man? All that shit is super fucking expensive.
Oh yeah, MAC stuff is righteously. I mean, that's not even like the high end stuff. MAC is just.
No, I know it.
It's more reasonable than the other stuff. I know way too much about these things now because I'm poor and I have a mortgage that I just look at and go, "Well, I'm gonna miss having walls, but fuck it, baby,
you look nice. My skin's gonna look good."
Yeah.
At least
I'm surprised for the bow. I'm surprised for the Bateman makeup, they don't mask the ingredients, you know? Just call it something else, like every time he comes in his pants when he kills somebody.
Yeah. Well, wow. You're reading the ingredient list, and it's like, okay, why does it say 50% Jeff? I don't understand.
Made of pure Jeff.
Now, is it BatemanSkincare.com? Is that the right one?
Yeah. BatemanSkincare.com. Yeah, okay. And it's a guy in a suit holding a attaché essentially full of.
Okay. Yeah. Cause I was looking at it and I'm like, rose hip and seaweed facial cleanser, $28.
Mm-hmm.
Like
now, I don't know the size of it. $28 is a reasonable amount of money to spend for.
It is 6 ounces.
Yeah.
That's what she said.
That sounds about right.
So it's essentially like a tablespoon or what?
Well, yeah.
Let's say right here we've got a 1 ounce bottle of, I don't even know what the hell it is, some sort of weird serum, $33 for 1 ounce. But its benefits: moisturizes the skin without oils, strengthens the epidermal barrier, stimulates the production of new collagen, perfect for oily and problematic skin.
Ashley, you don't want to have oily skin.
Your epidermal barrier strengthened for sure.
You don't want to have oily skin when you're holding an axe because, you know, it'll just make it slip right out of your hands.
Yeah, but to be honest, you use a pea to a dime size of that $33 shit. So it should last you a while. I'm not saying that $33 is not a lot because it'll last you a while, but
still. I mean, you've never had your wife like try to put on moisturizer or something, like she just got it coat all over her hands and she's like, "Oh, it took too much. Here, take this." And you're like, "I don't fucking want that on me. I don't need that shit." I think it breathes. It makes you need it. It's like once it gets in your skin, it just like, "I've absorbed all your moisture, now bring me more."
It changes your makeup.
Ingredients are like seaweed and water. It's like I can just go a mile down the road to the river and pick a fucking slab.
Brandon, you forget that your fucking microphone is attached to your face. when you like lean away from your computer like it's going to change something. The microphone is attached to your head.
It's not the mic, dude. It's not the mic. It's the window.
Oh, fine.
But fuck I did me, then. I forgot the mic. I forgot to mute it, though. You're right.
I don't care.
No, so fuck me.
I have a hard time. Right now? All right. Let's pause this so we can knock boots.
Whoa, buddy.
Why would you pause it? That's the only way we're going to get up to 10 listeners.
Oh, right. Just prepare for 47 seconds of grunting and more sweat. This episode Dumpster. Of the podcast here has 57% more sweat.
And a collective 3 inches between the four of us.
If you can bottle that, we can fucking sell it as a really product.
Sweaty inches.
Sweaty inches.
By pot.
Sweaty inches by pot. Oh, boy. Let's talk about Land of the Dead.
I don't know. That's the new podcast name right there. Sweaty Inches.
Sweaty Inches. There you go. Yeah, you guys are trying to start a new podcast. There you go. Sweaty Inches.
Sweaty Inches.
Brandon and
Ashley. Ashley Sweaty Inches.
Oh.
By Menon.
By Menon? Why is Menon? Do I even want to know?
Probably
no,
not.
No, I don't want to know. Yeah. Wait.
Wouldn't it be Menon?
Yeah, it would.
Probably.
It would.
So, Land of the Dead.
Thanks, Corey.
What we're here for.
It's like cats sometimes when I hang out with you guys.
Yeah. It's okay, yeah, so, but at the time that Matt edits this, we'll all have cut off half our conversation anyway.
No, I'm not. I'm done editing it. I'm done taking silence out. You can listen to uncomfortable silence and fucking like it.
And relish in it compared to the talking. You can just be like, oh, thank God. There's a buffer.
Oh, they finally shut the fuck up.
So you take that, you take that time of silence to apply sweaty inches. Every time you read silence, lather it on.
Oh, wow. All right. Yeah, see, so I forgot
perfect,
how bad
perfect time
is.
Right there.
I want to
let us know when you're done putting your sweaty inches on, and we'll continue.
You're never.
I'm looking
done.
Up the IMDb just to see if I've even seen this movie. Pretty it's sure I have.
It's got John Leguizamo in it.
Yeah,
that's the only like
the only redeeming quality for this movie for me is the Easter eggs and Leguizamo.
Leguizamo, Dennis Hopper, Simon Baker, and Asia Argento. There's actually some really good people in this.
It's got a great cast. Asia Argento was a big crush of mine when I was younger.
Don't blame you.
When I had a lesser palate for movies and I loved Triple X and all that shit, and she was in that, oh, I was into it.
Are you insinuating that you no longer love hardcore pornography?
Not with Vin Diesel, no.
Oh, I those Triple X's.
Oh, yeah. That's right. She was their little Russian chick there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm scoping out the IMDb right now.
This has great cameos with Nick Frost and Simon Pegg, and you get a zombified Dawn of the Dead. Matt, what's his name? Sex Machine.
What?
I am a sex machine. Sex machine.
You know Sex Machine from Dawn of the Dead?
Ugh, it's been... Hold on.
It's on the tip of my tongue.
I mean, he's the horror staple of everything. By the way, you were talking about...
Tom Savini, yeah.
Tom Savini.
Okay. Sorry. Yeah.
When you were saying... Shaun of the Dead, yeah, Edgar Wright and Simon Pegg both show up as photo booth zombies in this. There are quite a bit of Easter eggs. Greg Nicotero is the bridge keeper zombie. Greg, obviously associated with the Walking Dead show now.
Is that the one where they have the little photo booth with the zombies? And that's where you see, like...
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I've seen this. It's been a long time. Sorry, continue.
So, I wish that Nathan Fillion had the lead role in this movie. I feel like Simon, whatever his name is, the guy from the shows on network TV, The Mentalist, so on and so forth. I feel like he is a poor man's Nathan Fillion.
Oh, Simon Baker?
Yeah.
Yeah, they look alike. I
think of him more like Patrick Wilson.
Oh, see, really? I used to get Simon Baker mixed up with Ben McKenzie a lot.
What?
Like, they just look similar.
Fuck is Ben McKenzie? Are you cheating on me?
He's in like Is that his name? Or am I getting the name wrong?
I have no idea. I just
no. There's a guy named Ben McKenzie.
Okay, yeah, he plays in like Gotham and shit like that.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Okay. So I'm...
He was on the OC. Holy shit.
Oh yeah, he was a cop.
In fact,
that is
and
some
we
deep
had
cuts, man. I've never seen that show in my life.
The OC was on the movie we did last week with Brad, Jennifer's Body.
Oh yeah.
They're disinfecting everything. Oh, wait, no. This guy didn't show up in this, so I don't know why I'm making associations.
I don't know how I'm still awake right now. Let's just...
So, going back to the... This is George Romero returning to his Dead series. This is the fourth film in the series, but chronologically, it takes place last. I think it might also be his most successful of the films, if you don't count the Dawn of the Dead remake that was done by Zack Snyder just the year before this one came out. It had a reasonably high budget. I think it was about $19 million and was a success because it made about $40 million or so in the theaters and got reviewed by like Siskel gave it a 3 stars out of 5, I believe, and had some good things to say about it. It's, I don't see it. Like, I watch it, and I know that there is a bit of, like, it's a movie about class. It's a movie about the class system of the poor are living down on the ground, and then the rich are living up in the towers, and then the zombies are the ones that actually get to revolt.
Because
they distract them with things like fireworks at first, but then they stop paying attention. But I just don't know that it's... Yeah, go ahead, Matt.
No, I'm sorry. My deep exhale wasn't because you wouldn't let me talk. Sorry. I don't watch like the Dawn of the Dead and Day of the Dead for like a deep meaning of class systems and poor people. You know what I mean? So
that's the thing about the
whole point of a zombie movie, isn't it? Even with Walking Dead, the whole point is for us to look at ourselves and see how we devolve as society.
I just want to see people get fucking chewed apart.
But you get that. That's the thing, is you get that in this too, but there always has been in Romero's films that deeper meaning. If you go back to Night of the Living Dead, I mean, there's clearly issues of racism in that. It's dealing with the people in desperation of like how they'll force a distrust between each other because of how they're set up and their already deepening beliefs of like, I'm better than you and I don't want to protect you. I'm going to protect my own. If you follow Dawn of the Dead, it's about commercialism. It's about a lot of things that these themes are kind of what makes these films better than just people getting slashed or eaten or whatever. But I just don't think that it was done in such a way to really succeed in this. I think that the introduction of the intelligent zombies,
sentient zombies, really turned me off.
Sentient zombies, and just like I used to work at a gas station, and now I've got the ability to use a machine gun, and figure that stuff out, which is closer to Red Dawn than it is anything. it happens too quickly, and then the whole case system of Dennis Hopper is the rich guy living up in the tower. I don't understand the struggle between him and Leguizamo's character about money, because what the fuck is money?
That's one thing that bothered me, is like, why do you care about how expensive something is? Like, the world is crumbling around you. Why why do you have a money system in place?
You don't think that's Dennis Hopper? You don't think that's Dennis Hopper just taking advantage of the completely small-minded? They can't think outside of their own perspective, so they still are hung up on money despite society being crumbled.
But my basis for saying that your money system is stupid is because before you see, like the first time you're inside of Fiddler's Green, there's that chick like looking in a store window and they're talking about how expensive things are. Like, it would make more sense if that scene didn't exist and then you still had Dennis Hopper, who was playing an underling for money when money really doesn't matter anymore.
Yeah, one of the guys, one of the people who's sort of heading the buildup of the resistance in the people down on the streets says, you know, he didn't work to get up in that tower. He basically, he was just there and he took it And so now he's considered the king of all this, where the rest of us are considered the dregs because we're down here. And that I understand. If you somehow found your way into power because of this new system, that would make sense. But the emphasis on money in this really is where it falls apart, because money is just a promise. That's what money is today. Is it's just, that's why it's valueless in most cases, and why it costs more to make a penny than to actually have a penny. Mm-hmm. Because there's nothing to it other than the promise of exchanging for goods or services or something else like that. Gold is more of a value, and gold I don't even understand other than the fact that it can be used in conductive metal usage somewhere here and there. Diamonds, same sort of thing. If you can find value in how they can be used, I get it. But otherwise, yeah, it's an arbitrary value system that yeah, we created years and years ago.
Diamonds especially is a total farce. They're not even rare. It's right, just because the jeweler companies that hold conglomerates over all of the diamonds told us they're rare and they're expensive. It's the only yep, reason they're expensive.
Yeah.
It's funny how that theme is prevalent throughout the man in the high tower, so to speak. Like, if you, Ashley, with Walking Dead and Negan, it's funny how the masses just bend over to one guy who walks in and decides he's going to be in power, and that theme but is a super, lot of, supersedent throughout.
Yeah, a lot of times, like, if I'm trying to think how to phrase this, but like a lot of times in a situation where you don't really have, like, everyone's so hung up on like how shitty everything is, you just need someone to show up and swing their big dick around and be like, right, this is what's up, and then people will just fall into line.
People want someone to lead them. People want someone who will make decisions. That I buy into, that I understand. If you look at the Fifth Element, when Bruce Willis walks into the room and he shoots the leader of the warrior guys, and everybody else just like fucking drops, they're like, oh shit, now we don't know what to do because he was our leader. And that makes a degree of sense, because if there's the one person who's strong and has a plan, or at least has the balls to act like he has a plan, then people are going to fall in behind that person, because otherwise they just feel lost. They feel helpless. But there's someone pointing me at something to do. There's something that I feel like I can accomplish now because this person is giving me a direction. That I buy into. But the idea of, and Leguizamo's character in this, I buy into, I want to do these things so I can get myself up into that tower. I want to reach that level of success. So if it's real estate, I get that. I don't get, you're going to bring me $40 million. Like, where the fuck are you going to go that you're going to be able to spend that $40 million? The rest of the world you've already decided is like useless and dead. So you're going to take this cash and run off to no, and just spend your life counting it? That I don't get. That's the problem with this. And I think it's a shortcoming of the writing, or it's maybe it's just to show how ridiculous all of this is that we do believe in a money system. We do believe in this exchange of little pieces of fake paper and pretend that they have a value when they really don't. Maybe that's what he was trying to get across. It just didn't quite
make a point
for me.
Right, showing just that not everything is super materialistic.
Yeah, yeah, and I agree with that, but this is not the movie to do that in. It makes no sense. You are
it's totally trying to reach there in too many different directions.
Right. Good point.
False. Just separates the shepherds from the sheep.
Have any of you seen Diary of the Dead or Survival of the Dead? Are they any good?
No. I wanted Survival of the Dead to be great, but it just wasn't. After this movie, the budget just is gone, and it's just Diary of the Dead. I thought was horrible. Pretty sure Ving Rhames is in that one.
I didn't look
that but he's also in two of the Sharknadoes.
Touche. His star has fallen, I guess.
They apparently made a Diary of the Dead 2. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know.
I don't know.
Honestly, after I haven't the heard first, of it.
Yeah, the budget went down to $2 million.
Wow.
Which is insane, because
straight to video or what?
I think so.
So while we're on the zombie topic, if any of this had happened and we'd...
Oh, it went to theaters. Sorry.
Did it really?
Yeah.
Diary of the Dead also had Tatyana Maslany in it from Orphan Black.
Really?
Yeah. So, I mean, I would watch it just to see her early work and see either one, if she was that brilliant then, or if she was just... Like, she's grown so much from that, because she is really good on Orphan Black.
I do not remember any brilliance in that movie. That was the total aside for me when I saw that. I wanted it to be good.
George Romero won a 2008 Critics Award for Diary of the Dead, and it has a 62% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Well, I totally disagree because I just did not like it.
Oh,
I don't go by anything Rotten Tomatoes says.
No, no.
Not now that they've been bought, no.
Yeah, I don't even know if I ever want to watch this movie.
And Matt, I had sent you in our Slack the link to, there was a Land of the Dead video game for PC.
Yeah, Road to Fiddler's Green.
Wow.
There was a prequel for this. So maybe that fills in some of the story of the movie. I don't really know, but it seemed to be trying to do too many different things and none of them really well. We get to the point of, at the beginning, we are introduced to the Big Daddy character, which is the zombie that starts to show sentience.
Which annoyed the shit out of me. What annoyed me the most is when he has the gun and he like freaks out and shoots and then realizes, oh, I'll just point this and it'll hurt people. Like, that's
right.
I get that there's,
but your hand automatically landed where your finger is on the trigger.
Yep.
And you're just figuring this out as you go along. Like, why did you feel the need to pick it up at all? Is it that he's slowly remembering how to be human or what?
The way that they kind of lead into it at the beginning of the movie is that they're starting to learn and figure things out. So by saying that, like, the fact that he just pulls the trigger on accident and then he just knows, oh, I can shoot people with this. Like, why not set it up where he has the gun, pulls the trigger, and then sees someone get shot and then puts two and two together? You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, there's better ways that you could have done a lot of this stuff.
I just don't think they should do that at all with zombies. The whole point is
I agree.
They're the dead risen. It's decay. Like, so you've erased their humanity and now you're going to go all Planet of the Apes with it? Like, I don't need that.
Yeah, and then we get the final moral lesson at the end where Simon Baker as Riley is like, oh, don't shoot them. They're just looking for a place of their own. It's like,
yeah,
what kind of fucking determination is that? They're still going to eat people when they run into them. Could be you. Should be you at this point. Maybe you fucking destroy them because that's all they're ever going to fucking do. I think it's even said in the movie is that by the time the dead are done with what they're doing, it's because we're gone. Is that there's none of us left for them to eat and kill.
Yeah.
So you should fucking get rid of them while you have the opportunity. There might be other people in that city that you were just freaking out about. Like, maybe we should try to save these people in the city. Oh, nope. Fuck it. Just let them all rot. Let them all get eaten now.
Yeah, it's fine. It'll be fine.
I think that there's too many messages that are trying to come across in this movie. We get into the point where we have like a Thunderdome situation with Asia Argento's Slack. Fighting against zombies in this cage with the Chihuahua guy.
Am I the only one that was somehow boner-inducing to watch?
Yeah.
I mean, never mind the allegories to Master Blaster and shit, but, like, I don't know. Asia Argento trying to be getting eaten isn't arousing.
Oh, I thought you meant because of the two zombies that got sprayed in the face. I thought that was doing it for you.
Yeah, that too.
Or Phil Fondacaro getting into the movie. You know, I liked Phil. What was the movie you did with the Blood Dolls or something?
You picked that. Don't put that evil on me, Ricky Bobby.
I love that movie.
It was so bad.
But it's always nice to see him show up in things. But he was there for just a short time. There's too many elements in this. The case system, the what happened with the car. Like, the whole thing of, like, oh, I was supposed to have a car. Someone took my car. Now I'm going to go steal this giant truck, even though I was told to go steal the giant truck. Now it's, like, me subverting the movie. It's too many elements to make it work into a cohesive story. I think George felt like, oh, I've got an opportunity to come back to these films now. They're getting popular again. And he had so many ideas, and he used all of them, and he maybe should have shown her a little bit of restraint. Right. Now, full disclosure, I've written a comic book with John Russo, the co-writer of the original Night of the Living Dead, so I may have some bias.
Touche.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that.
Acceptable.
Yeah. What else happened in this movie?
We can talk about Charlie.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I don't know how I feel about that character. Charlie was a simple friend.
But he was your of mice and men character, man.
Yeah.
Loyal to the end.
Super clutch.
Yeah.
there was, I mean, as weird as it is, there was some good loyalty examples in this movie. Charlie was definitely one, and Riley in return was loyal. Then we saw the big Samoan guy knock out the two people he was with and leave one of them to just fucking die. Yeah. So maybe not as loyal there, but he does come through in the end as well. Slack is loyal, but Fox, the guy who's hanging out with Leguizamo's Cholo character, is also loyal to him in the end. And we know that Cholo just would go and lead people to their death when they were out on runs because Dennis Hopper's character wanted them gone. He thought they were part of the resistance. So he's like, yeah, make sure this guy's killed, which we see act out when he throws all the cigars on the floor and tells the guy to pick it up. And then the zombie bites him. Like, it's in some ways there's a definite humanity to these people, and in other ways they're still opportunists. Mm-hmm. But it shows that, you know, we did runs together. I'm going to help you. I'm going to try to keep you alive. When Riley has the opportunity to basically kill Cholo, he doesn't do it. Cholo still winds up dead. And also, that's another part, is there's no real payoff with the Cholo-Kaufman confrontation. It's like they shoot at each other, but in the end, it's Big Daddy who kills them both very quickly. Mm-hmm. And I feel like that was a lot of buildup to nothing.
I'm super sad about Leguizamo. I wish that, just in general, he was more famous. I love Leguizamo. Have you ever seen Freak, the one-man show?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I've seen several of his one-man shows. I mean, he's great.
Freak, the original one, Freak, really defined my childhood. I watched that over and over and over again. It was always in jokes between me and my friends. We would all watch that. And I don't know, he was just a big part of my life at one point, and I wish that he would have been... It's not that he's not famous. I just wish that his roles would have been better. Like, this is for movies, like, you can't expect much more than this or Summer of Sam, which that was a great movie, but I would love to have had more of him in my life.
Yeah,
there's
my
ode to Leguizamo right there.
I feel like I.
And Spawn. Let's not forget Spawn.
I
liked him in Spawn.
As the Violator. He's great in so many things, but it's not like he hasn't had success. And he's better because he gets to be a character actor. He's going to be in John Wick 2. But he's done the Ice Age movies, which, like, the guy's got a shit ton of money he's probably sitting on at this point.
Oh, I don't doubt it.
He's reached a level of success that is probably far better than the guy who started out doing, what was the movie, like, his comedy way back when? Jesus.
Which one? He was in Super Mario Brothers. He was. In,
with
Dennis Hopper.
Recovering so this also bad. Here. Probably a big deal.
To Wong Fu.
Oh, I love that movie. That movie's great.
I have that movie. I love
The Pest.
The Pest. That was the one I was thinking of. Yep. Like, how do you recover from The Pest?
Oh, God. He was in Miami Vice for a while.
I don't understand how.
Small roles, but.
Yeah, I don't understand how Gyllenhaal recovered from Bubble Boy, but sometimes it happens.
But he also did Donnie Darko, though, before Bubble Boy.
Right.
Which Leguizamo did Romeo and Juliet and Carlito's Way all before he did The Pest. He did a shit ton of movies before he did The Pest.
I mean, he's been, that's exactly it. He's a character actor. He's done a ton of stuff. He's been, even if he's in a shit movie, he's been great in it. He's somebody that you just kind of go, fucking...
Holy
John
Leguizamo's
in this. I'll watch it.
He started acting in 1985 was his first movie. He's consistently put out movies to present, and only 4 years has he only put out one movie.
Well,
wrap your fucking mind around that. In 2008, he put out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 movies. He was in 6 movies.
And it's probably in those years that he only put out one, he was probably doing stage stuff.
Yeah.
So then I guess I should retract my statement and dig a little deeper. Apparently there's lots of Leguizamo out there for me to get.
Well, keep in mind, like, he probably was, these are probably all small roles.
Right.
Like Dr. Doolittle, he was the voice of the rat. So
yeah, he's done a lot of voiceover work because he's got a really good ability to do voices and characters. That's why you love the dude.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like,
I like him.
I also feel like we're undercutting what another big deal about this movie is it is Dennis Hopper, and it's pretty close to when we lost Dennis Hopper, I
yeah,
think.
It's not. Is it his last role? I meant to look and see if it was.
I'll look it up.
You notice with Dennis Hopper and Charlie, if you look at Hopper in Waterworld, he licks his gun sight. He licks his finger and then, you know, polishes his gun sight, and then Charlie does the same thing in this movie.
Yeah. No, he was in Alpha and Omega in 2010. And then there's been other things that have been released more recently, mm-hmm. 2015, 2016. But the Crash TV series was 2008 to 2009. So I assume, yeah, he passed away in 2010. So it's that was further out than what I thought from this. But I still can't think of a lot of big roles that he was doing at that point in time.
I didn't realize how old he was.
Oh, yeah.
Born in 36.
Yeah, I mean, you go back to, I always think back to Easy Rider.
Yeah, he was in his 40s then, wasn't he? Or more.
What year was that?
That was in the 70s, right? Or 60s.
First acting role was in 1954.
Wow. Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah, wow. Holy shit.
So, I mean, you can't fault this movie for the cast, for the choices of who was in it. That's probably where a lot of the budget went to, because I feel like the zombie effects and everything, none of them were anything that we hadn't seen before. And I'm certainly desensitized to all of it now after watching several seasons of The Walking Dead, that idea of it's all been done. Yeah. But it really felt like a general sameness even just after the Dawn of the Dead remake. We've seen so much of this stuff. I think one of the bigger things they had to edit out for the release of the film was the girl's belly button ring getting ripped out by the zombie. They put effects in front of that to block it, to get it a rating for, I think, either PG-13 or R in some places.
Huh. Weird.
As a general rule. Yeah, are you all right?
Yeah, I just, like, a coughing fit. I got a tickle.
I saw some craziness going on there. As a general rule, do you prefer the slow-moving zombie or the fast-moving zombie?
Slow.
The modern, yeah, I like slow too, but
that's yeah. Like traditional zombies move slow. Like,
well, it seems like your contemporary zombie outside of The Walking Dead, when it was just movies and like Dawn of the Dead remake, you're getting and fucking 28 Days Later, you're getting the fast moving zombie.
Mm-hmm. Well, it wasn't 28 Days Later more of an outbreak film than a zombie.
Yeah, it was a virus. It was the Rage right. virus. Again, like. Yeah. I mean, to I the layman that hasn't seen that movie, doesn't it looks like a zombie movie. That's what you're
right.
going to say.
It's played in with similarities to zombie films, but it's not really zombies. And that I can get the difference, and I'm okay with that. But you're right. Fast-moving zombies don't feel right to me, because the whole point of zombies is they move slow because rigor mortis is already set in. You know, they're not used to their musculature and everything. It's not like they've been working out and stuff. I feel like that when I got out of bed most of the time. I'm fucking dying.
I have rigor mortis in all the wrong places now. Yeah.
And just never in the right one.
Poor guy.
Oh, shit. All right.
See, but that's counter to this whole movie, again, with sentient zombies. Like, you're a rotting animated thing. You should not have any fucking smarts.
No, none whatsoever. I mean, if it was like an infection movie, like 28 Days Later, I could see being smart or getting smart or moving fast, but not if you're a zombie, no.
Well, also the points where it's like I'm holding just a head and the head's still alive, that always kind of bugs me too.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like I get the idea of separating the brain and that's what kills them and stuff, but you've separated it from their entire circulatory system at this point. It's not even got a heart or anything to pump the blood to it. I think maybe that's a little too far. I get that it makes a good visual. I really like the visual of the one kind of a security guy where the zombie comes up to him and it's got no head, and then the head flips over and bites him. That was like, that was a really cool scene, but it's ridiculous. And I'd much rather have it in a fully ridiculous movie than something that's trying to make points and be relevant at the same time.
Right. Right. Yeah.
Cool.
I was waiting for someone else to talk.
Does anybody think the butler got away? I really wanted him to.
He's the one who had the car.
Boss.
He got away.
But he ran up to where Big Daddy, apparently was or came down from at some point. So, like, I have a feeling he met his end, but I really wanted him to get away. He's like, from the very beginning, he opens the door and he's ready to kill somebody. Like, oh, I didn't know it was you. And so he knows to hesitate, too. I thought, like, he was the most interesting character, you know, other than Asia Argento to look at.
Yeah.
Keep going back to that, huh?
She's a very attractive lady, you know, and she's got great pedigree. You know,
she's bred with good genes. No, okay. Thanks, guys.
Leave you hanging.
Yeah, I'm used to it.
Just grab at those sweaty inches.
I'm sweating my balls off right now.
Yeah, I can see the alcohol pouring out of you.
I need to take a shower after this. I feel so
can gross. We just like set a match to you and see what happens?
I'd burn my house down. At least my breath stopped tasting like stale beer.
Ugh.
Yeah, I got that going for me.
I don't miss those days. I'm glad I didn't do that last night.
It was on accident. I didn't do it on purpose.
Oh, these beers all just accidentally fell down my throat.
Well, I didn't like wake up yesterday morning and I'm like, let's fucking do this. I just like started having fun and they just kept going down.
If your breath doesn't taste like beer, how do you know you're even alive at this point? That's what I kind of wonder.
Jesus. You win.
Fucking sentient zombie. God damn it.
God damn it.
Is there anything else to say or you guys want to rate this thing?
We can rate it.
We can just sit here in silence for 45 minutes too, for all I care. Not really. Let's not do that. Just go take a shower or something. All right, let's rate this movie. We'll do it on our patented copyrighted. It's not really copyrighted. Maybe I should copyright it. The old FAP scale. We'll do it in three little Husker doos. We're going to do the feature, the attention, and the panic. 0 to 5 scale. Let's let Ashley go first. We'll do feature first. That's how'd you like the movie? 0 to 5. Ready, set, go.
That's a great question. Seems I didn't watch it before I came on here.
No, I didn't ask if you watched it. I said, how'd you like it? Based on the description, based on the conversation we just had about this movie, how'd you like it?
Yeah. I'd give it probably 2.
Fair enough.
A 2? Oh.
Brandon, sound really sad about that.
I am a little bit sad about it.
How'd you like this? It's your turn, buddy.
I give it a 5. Is that 5 FAPs? Is that what that is?
No, it's just 5. We'll give you an overall FAP score later.
I can remember.
Oh, okay.
Fair enough.
I'd give it a 5. I mean, I enjoy it. It's fun to watch. Again, Leguizamo, Hopper, Asia.
Asia.
It's Asia.
Great band.
Right? Yeah.
Corey, how about you?
Big bag full of money to the rains down in Africa.
Oh, and Dead Reckoning.
I was going in my head.
Funny story, I'm going to see Asia and Journey in March.
Are you really?
Yeah, my wife really, really likes Journey.
Is that the band that has the new frontman who's like Filipino, or is that Foreigner?
No, that's Journey, right? Yeah. This will be like the third time we've seen him.
Wow.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. One time.
Enjoy. I hope you add one of those to your vinyl collection, man.
Vinyl. You just reminded me I have to go pick up something at Bull Moose.
Should have fucking bought it when we were there the first time, but okay.
Oh, what was it? What is it?
It's a Ghost of Paul Revere vinyl edition of their album, Believe.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, I was out Christmas shopping and I was refraining from buying myself things.
I heard Ashley and vinyl. I assumed it was adult store somewhere and she was going to get some vinyl wear.
Jesus.
Corey. I need a gag man dive suit.
Corey, how did you like this movie?
Brandon just did bring something up that I forgot about in the movie, and that was Dead Reckoning, the name of badass super truck that I think that was actually supposed to be the name of the movie. And Romero fought for that, didn't want to give Fox the rights to Night of Living Dead, which is what they were trying to get out of him. They were trying to get him to call it Night of Living Dead 2 or Night of Living Dead Dead Reckoning because they wanted to get the copyright on that name. He's like, no, fuck you guys. But that part of it was, again, it's one part that probably could have been almost a whole movie in and of itself is based around that thing. And they didn't utilize it correctly in this. So as far as the feature, I feel like the feature was just kind of all over the place. I'm going to agree with Ash. I'm going to give it a 2.
Yeah, that's right, buddy.
What do you... Well, I hope you win, actually.
Yeah. I always win.
I'll split the difference. I gave it a 3. It's decent, but meh. Decent. Too many holes. Dick joke, anybody?
Every time I don't know. Every time I hear the word decent, I just refer to Bubbles.
It's a nice fucking kitty. Let's see.
Dick joke, pussy joke. Everybody wins.
Oh, boy.
Dumpster slut jokes, you know.
Dumpster sluts. I forgot. Oh, fuck. Okay, so...
It's funny how everybody perks up as soon as the topic goes away.
Yeah, I know, right?
Oh, we're talking about the movie? Well, we better not say anything. Wait, dicks and pussy are back? Okay, let's all jump in.
everyone get a little...
Hey, awkward. I warned you. I didn't watch this beforehand, and I haven't seen it in a very long time.
That's fine.
You're smarter than all of us.
Let's
I known.
Let's do the A.
Let's do it in the A.
Let's do it in the A. The attention of the movie is 0 to 5. How likely are you to rewatch this movie, Ashley?
I'm gonna stick with a sturdy 2.
All right. I like your answers are nice and short because you didn't watch it. Brandon, how about you?
I am matured past the days of fapping to Asia Argento, so probably a 1. A nice stiff 1, not going to rewatch.
Wow. Corey, how about you?
I'll go 2 again on this because I think the performances of the actors are good. I just don't think that there was much for them to utilize.
Their material was junk.
Yeah.
I'm going to give it a 2. I kind of agree with everything that Corey said. Lastly, the panic, the pee. We're at the end of our fapping.
The pee.
How scary was this movie? Ashley, did this movie scare the shit out of you when you recently watched it?
Absolutely not.
No? So you gotta give it a number. You can't read your mind. No one is.
Oh. One?
There you go.
I didn't know.
Big 1. Sorry. Oh, that's fine. Brandon.
Yeah, I'm going to have to agree with a 1. It's a Hollywood movie. It's not scary.
Yeah. Corey.
Yeah, I'm always unsure because scariness is a hard thing to rate. As far as effects, gore, and everything, it's just so mediocre. It's too bad because the expectation of these things is Romero films is where they're going to get you some original ideas and stuff. There was nothing original to this, so I'm going to also give it a 1.
Fair enough. I'm just going to go with a 0. There really wasn't much to it.
That's not an option. That's not an option.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, yeah. 0 to 5.
0 to 5.
Oh, yeah. I thought you said 1 to 5.
No. Well, you want to go back and change your number to a 0?
No, okay. I'm good.
Welcome 0 to 5.
Your arbitrary number for the film you didn't watch?
Right?
That's really your point.
The Psychic Friends edition of the FAP score?
I just like to be difficult. That's all.
That's what
I noticed. Awesome. Cool. That's the end of our FAPPY. You can contact us by leaving us a voicemail at 805-328-3966. You can email us at pot@gncast.com. Leave us a message on the website. Tell us what you like, what you don't like. Maybe you want more dick jokes, less dick jokes.
More fap.
Less fap. Well, you want us to have a dick joke of the week section? Fuck.
You want us to say fuck the movies and talk about dick for an hour?
Yeah. Wait, we'll do horror news and then talk about dick for half an hour.
Good news is we already do that.
That's true. We just pepper in movie talk with dick talk. You can follow us. What?
Well, yeah, I was going to say, it's the only reason I'm here.
Fair enough.
That's for peppery dick.
Peppery dick.
I feel like that's my fault. I mean, I don't hear, you know, it's pretty on point when I'm not around, so.
Fair enough. You can follow the show on Twitter and Instagram at the podcast, @podcastofterror, not the. Subscribe to the podcast via iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play, any of your favorite podcatchers. Leave us feedback. If you leave feedback, we'll read it and then talk about how much we love you. That's a thing that happens here.
That's true. We do. Sometimes we just let people who watch us show up.
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
It's true.
And we're better for it.
Something like that.
Aw, thank you, Corey.
Why don't you two get a fucking room? All subscription options and links can be found at gncast.com/subscribe.
I need a room. I'm not going to put a dumpster in there.
That was a good one. That was a zinger. Zing!
Oh, you win. You win today.
You could join us on Facebook under the Galactic Network. Brandon, Ashley, where can people find you? You guys have to fight over who goes first. I don't care.
Ashley. Ashley's behind the big slots, and
Ashley's up from the Quiver Bar.
Oh shit! Well, I do have Facebook. It's not that hard. Ashley Gagner. I have an Instagram, Mick Gagner face. Email if anybody ever wants to talk to me. Probably not. AshleyG9984@gmail.com. Hopefully one of these days I will be hopping on this bandwagon of podcasting a little bit more, work on something. We'll see.
Brandon, it's your turn now.
I don't know. She did such a good job. I just can't compete. Can find me at... Go ahead. Know what?
Are you flicking me off? Are you flicking me off? Looks like you're flicking me off right now.
Oh boy, they're fighting like normal people fight.
Well, right. So you can find me at igstudios.com. With my friend Nate Ward, we do we did podcasts. We'll do them again at some point. So that's inkgeekstudios.com.
I've got two podcasts on my feed from you guys that are still like Jackie Hearn's on both of them, which is nice because we love Jackie. But right. Just in general, it's like, oh, here's the oh no, it's still that one. Okay, yep. Well, maybe right. No, not yet. I'm waiting.
We'll be back soon. I mean, it's the new year, so we'll start again. I definitely need to get on Sonics and Sabres, given that Doctor Who is kind of back. Oh! I can't talk about Doctor Who here. My bad.
That's what I mean.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
New Star Wars release. You know, there's a lot to talk about now. People died. Carrie Fisher died. Her mother died.
Right. That's sad. Sad stuff.
Yeah, I'm not too broken up about it.
A lot of people
Matt's
die.
Matt's not crying at all. Matt's like, yeah, fuck it.
No, it sucks, but a lot of people die every year. Anyways, Corey, where can people find you?
People can find the comics that I work on at donutscomics.com. Also, if you're at all interested, and I'm not saying you should be, I wrote a couple stories there on Wattpad. You can look me up as Captain Temerity on Wattpad and read some shit, and I'm going to try to throw more stuff up there soon.
Awesome. We love you, Corey. You can find me on Twitter and Instagram at Matt the Lifeguard. That's going to do it. Thanks. Talk to you guys next time. Bye. All right. I'm going to stop YouTube.